the Chinese Grand Prix had a lot to live up to following the thrills of Bahrain. And despite Mercedes not mounting much of a challenge to Ferrari in qualifying, Shanghai's largely open throttle lap looked full of promise. In the end, thematically at least, it shared a lot with last week's race. Bottas dueling with a Ferrari at the front, a charge for the podium from behind, and Max Verstappen firing things up, for better or worse. It escalated quickly. After an opening switcheroo that saw Kimi and Lewis lose a place, the first 20 or so laps looked like a holding pattern special for the front of the grid. Sebastian Vettel went about extending his lead over Bottas, and in turn, the top six opened an unassailable lead to everyone else. Acts 2 and 3 however provided much excitement, chess-like pit strategy, collisions, dive bomb overtakes and an underdog charging to victory. Here's what we learned from the 2018 Chinese Grand Prix. 1. The emerging vocabulary of pit strategy. Do you know your double stack from your undercut? You'd better read up. If not, the Mercedes car's early pit stop helped put Bottas in front of the Ferraris, while the minutely orchestrated one-in-one out from Red Bull lit the fuse for Ricciardo's run to victory. 2. Patience is king. After that tactical tire swap behind the pace car, the race was Verstappen's to lose, but he went after first place like a boxer looking for a bout winning haymaker, ultimately resulting in him running wide around Hamilton and then colliding with Vettel at turn 14. Ricciardo on the other hand timed his assault to perfection, picked his punches, and reeled the podium in one stunning overtake at a time. 3. Bittersweet gain for Lewis. Hamilton reduced the gap to Vettel in Shanghai, just 9 points separates the two drivers, and Mercedes has moved to the top of the constructors' table. When you look at it like that, not a bad day at all. Every silver lining is a cloud though. Here's Lewis's take on things. Yesterday and today have been a disaster on my side. The Mercedes driver has promised normal performance mode will resume though. 4. Sometimes you've just got to lick the stamp and send it. Expect to see Ricciardo's podium quote lined up next to an Eva Bean Nürburgring logo and a Brian O'Connor "dude I almost had you" sticker on a modified car bumper near you. 5. The shoey is back. It's a divisive celebration, but we're delighted to see the shoey celebration hasn't been outlawed along with all the other changes F1 has undergone since last season. A bit gross? Yes. Slightly weird? Yes, but when was the last time you hosed someone down with a massive bottle of champagne? The F1 podium is an odd place. Also intriguing was the six-month illness Martin Brundle claimed to have suffered from after the last time he drank wine from a racing boot. Maybe it was tonsillitis, sorry. 6. 2018. A vintage year. That's a decent 2 out of 3 races now. With Vettel's path to victory far from assured, big improvements promised by Lewis Hamilton, and all eyes on Red Bull for exciting twists and turns, this season is shaping up very nicely indeed.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe now.